Today we're going to read the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapters 18 and 19. This is Ecclesiasticus, or Sirach, chapter 18. He that liveth forever created all things in general. The Lord only is righteous, and there is none other but he, who governeth the world with the palm of his hand, and all things obey his will, for he is the king of all, by his power, dividing holy things among them from profane. To whom have he given power to declare his works? And who shall find out his noble acts? Who shall number the strength of his majesty? And who shall also tell out his mercies? As for the wondrous works of the Lord, there may nothing be taken from them, neither may anything be put unto them, neither can the ground of them be found out. When a man have done, then he beginneth, and when he leaveth off, then he shall be doubtful. What is man, and whereto serveth he? What is his good, and what is his evil? The number of a man's days at the most are 100 years. As a drop of water unto the sea, and a gravel stone in comparison of the sand, so are 1,000 years to the days of eternity. Therefore is God patient with them, and pour forth his mercy upon them. He saw and perceived their end to be evil, therefore he multiplied his compassion. The mercy of man is toward his neighbor, but the mercy of the Lord is upon all flesh. He reproveth and nurtureth, and teacheth and bringeth again, as a shepherd his flock. He had mercy on them that receive discipline, and that diligently seek after his judgments. My son, blemish not thy good deeds, neither use uncomfortable words when thou givest anything. Shall not the dew assuage the heat? So is a word better than a gift. Lo, is not a word better than a gift? But both are with a gracious man. A fool will braid churlishly, and a gift of the envious consumeth the eyes. Learn before thou speak, and use physic, or ever thou be sick. Before judgment examine thyself, and in the day of visitation thou shalt find mercy. Humble thyself before thou be sick, and in the time of sins shew repentance. Let nothing hinder thee to pay thy vow in due time, and defer not until death to be justified. Before thou prayest, prepare thyself, and be not as one that tempteth the Lord. Think upon the wrath that shall be at the end, and the time of vengeance, when he shall turn away his face. When thou hast enough, remember the time of hunger, and when thou art rich, think upon poverty and need. From the morning until the evening, the time is changed, and all things are soon done before the Lord. A wise man will fear in everything, and in the day of sinning, he will beware of offense, but a fool will not observe time. Every man of understanding knoweth wisdom, and will give praise unto him that found her. They that were of understanding and sayings became also wise themselves, and poured forth exquisite parables. Go not after thy lusts, but refrain thyself from thine appetites. If thou givest thy soul the desires that please her, she will make thee a laughingstock to thine enemies that malign thee. Take not pleasure in much good cheer, neither be tied to the expense thereof. Be not made a beggar by banqueting upon borrowing, when thou hast nothing in thy purse, for thou shalt lie in wait for thine own life and be talked on. This is Ecclesiasticus, or Sirach, chapter 19. A laboring man that is given to drunkenness shall not be rich, and he that contemneth small things shall fall by little and little. Wine and women will make men of understanding to fall away, and he that cleaveth to harlots will become impudent. Moths and worms shall have him to heritage, and a bold man shall be taken away. He that is hasty to give credit is light-minded, and he that sinneth shall offend against his own soul. Whoso taketh pleasure in wickedness shall be condemned, but he that resisteth pleasures crowneth his life. He that can rule his tongue shall live without strife, and he that hateth babbling shall have less evil. Rehearse not unto another that which is told unto thee, and thou shalt fare never the worse. Whether it be to friend or foe, talk not of other men's lives, and if thou canst without offense, reveal them not. For he heard and observed thee, and when time cometh, he will hate thee. If thou hast heard a word, let it die with thee, and be bold, it will not burst thee. A fool travaileth with a word as a woman in labor of a child. As an arrow that sticketh in a man's thigh, so is a word within a fool's belly. Admonish a friend, it may be he have not done it, and if he have done it, that he do it no more. Admonish thy friend, it may be he have not said it, and if he have, that he speak it not again. Admonish a friend, for many times it is a slander, and believe not every tale. There is one that slippeth in his speech, but not from his heart, and who is he that have not offended with his tongue? Admonish thy neighbor before thou threaten him, and not being angry, give place to the law of the Most High. The fear of the Lord is the first step to be accepted of him, and wisdom obtained of his love. The knowledge of the commandments of the Lord is the doctrine of life, and they that do these things, and they that do things that please him, shall receive the fruit of the tree of immortality. The fear of the Lord is all wisdom, and in all wisdom is the performance of the law, and the knowledge of his omnipotency. If a servant say to his master, I will not do as it pleaseth thee, though afterward he do it, he angereth him that nourisheth him. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, neither at any time the counsel of sinners prudence. There is a wickedness, and the same an abomination. And there is a fool wanting in wisdom. He that has small understanding and fear of God is better than one that hath much wisdom and transgresseth the law of the Most High. There is an exquisite subtlety, and the same is unjust, and there is one that turneth aside to make judgment appear, and there is a wise man that justifieth in judgment. There is a wicked man that hangeth down his head sadly, but inwardly he is full of deceit, casting down his countenance and making as if he heard not. Where he is not known, he will do a mischief before thou be aware. And if for want of power he be hindered from sinning, yet when he findeth opportunity, he will do evil. A man may be known by his look, and one that have understanding by his countenance, when thou meetest him. A man's attire and excessive laughter and gait shew what he is. That's Ecclesiasticus chapters 18 and 19. Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, Barakatham, and as always, double shalom.